One small positive thought in the morning can change your whole day. Welcome to Bharat Education Society, Kartika High School and Junior College. Welcome students to computer online class for class 8. I, Mrs. Savita Srivastava, your computer teacher. So, let us begin with a new chapter of MS Access. So, let us learn Chapter 9, Access Queries. So, let's get started. The power of queries. A database has the potential to reveal complex trends and activities. But this power is only harnessed through the use of the query. A complex database consists of many tables storing a large amount of data. A query allows you to filter the data into a single table so that you can analyze it more easily. Query can also perform calculation on your data or automate data management tasks. You can also review updates to your data before committing them to the database. For example, calculating product discount, percentage of marks, salary deduction, interest rate, etc. You can set the relation and find out these queries from the database. Here, the database plays an important role, which is consists of different tables. And the table is consist of different records. So we require database with millions of records on which we can set the query. And it is very difficult to search the query from the database. So we require the SQL structured query language, which can be used to create a query in database. What is the definition of database query? A database query extracts data from a database and format it into a human-readable form. A query must be written in the syntax the database requires, usually a variant of structured query language, that is SQL. So, database uses structured query language on which we can make a set of queries. For example, employee database of a company. So with the help of this employee database, I can explain you how the queries can be used. For example, first one, retrieve the name of the managers of different department of a company. So here the query will be set in SQL for searching the name of the manager of different departments of a company. Second, retrieve the name of clerical staff of a company's administrator department. So query will be set to find out name of clerical staff of a company, and it will display in the format of table with the different names of clerical staff. Next one is retrieve the salary list of the employees of the company department wise. So there are a number of department in the companies, so the salary list will be displayed of the employee in table format with the different department wise. Next one is retrieve the attendance of the employee of a company's department wise. So here the attendance of the employee, the query will be setting for finding out the attendance, so how many days they have given the service to the company. So you can set the query to find out the attendance of the employee. Next is to retrieve the name of the employee whose salary is more than 1 lakh per month. So it will set the query to find out the name of the employees whose salary is more than 1 lakh per month. So these are all different queries example I had explained you, which is based on the employee database of a company. So Let us start with the chapter Access Query. In this chapter, it is explained the use of query. You use query to view, change and analyze data in different way. Means we can find out the different queries by using different tables of the database by setting the relation and set the query from different tables. So you can also use them as a source of records for forms, reports and data access pages. For example, the school database. From that I want the marks of the student who has scored 95%. So we can create a report on by using the query. So this is the example we can use for query. The most common type of query used by design view is the select. So mostly the query is written in structured query language, that is SQL, where select query is used by using design view. The retrieve data from one table or more table and display the result in a data sheet. So when the query is written, it displays the output in the form of table by using a data sheet where you can update the records after meeting certain condition. Means you can give a criteria or certain condition can be mentioned while giving the query. You can use query to group records and calculate sum, count, average and other types of total. So we can also do the calculation work to find out the total sum, to find out the counts, to find out the average or percentage and other types of calculation data. A query can be created in design view. So we can create a query by using design view tab from the view tabs. Now let us start creating a query using design view. The design view allows you to create a query from scratch. Let us create a query using table students and student detail to retrieve the roll number, names, phone number of the students. So steps are, first one, click on the create tab in the database window. So we have to click on create tab. Then second is click on query design button in the other group. So here there is a create option from where we can create a query from the database. So click on query design. Here will be the query design button in the other groups. So click to choose the table. Now select the table. So choose table will be option will be available here. So we have to select choose table. And fourth one is to add the table. So we have to add the tables for the queries. Whichever table is required, we can add it by using a show table. Next is click on close button after selecting the table or adding the tables. The query design view window open. Now you need to add the fields you wish to include in the query. So after adding the tables, you can add the fields for the queries which are required. So let us continue further. Now here you can see the relation is set on student name of student and student name of student detail. So the relation is set on the common field whose primary key is already set on these fields. So drag the fields age and class from student table window and drop it in the first and second column in the query window. So here we can add the name, age, class and division. So this way we are setting the query by using this query window. So all the details can be selected over here. table name, fields, then sorting criteria can be given over here in this query window. To execute the query, click on run button in the result group on the query toolbar. So on the query tool group, there is a run button, so you can run the query and you can see the access retrieve of all the fields and records for the table and display them in the datasheet view. The query which is set will be displayed in the form of table and it will give the output on the screen by using a datasheet view. For instance, you wish to retrieve the student name of all students. The fields required are, so here we are using a single table where we are retrieving the name of all the students. So we select the table name and the field name and we select on the, we give the tick mark here for the fields. So whichever all the records and the field name, the name we have taken, student name. So this names of the student will be displayed from student table, okay? So these are the name of the students. So all students' names are displayed. So this is one query which is set in Access. In the last, you have to save the query. Click on the Quick Access toolbar. Choose Save Type and name the query as Phone. So here we have given the name as, query name as Students. So here it is saved by the name of query as Student. So you can give any name for the query as per the records which you want to display. So in this you can see the student name is displayed with age, class and division. So this is the first query which we can set and display in the form of tables. So this is a query which is displayed in the form of table and we save it with the query name Student and just click on OK to save it. Opening and modifying the query. So to open the query, just click on, right click on the query name and select design view. So design view, which where we can make the modification or changes in the query. Here we had made the changes for setting all the records in ascending order. So all the records which are there in the table will be displayed in the ascending order. So here it is given, click on the sort row, second column is drop down arrow appearance and select an option of list ascending. This will sort the student name in the ascending order. So the name of the student will be in alphabetic ascending order A to Z. To save the changes in the query, click on File and select Choose Save option. To execute the query, click on Run. So we have to click on Run from the query menu. So this is way we can make use of query by using a database. Now you can see the list will be now sorted in the ascending order as shown in the figure. So as we have given set the query on student name for ascending order, so it is displaying 1, 2, 3, 4 where we have given the name in the form of numbers. So it is showing the records in ascending order, that is 0 to 9. So this way you can set the query to display the records in the form of table. Now let us learn online in MS Access how to create query using Query Wizard and Query Design. Chapter 9, Access Query, practical session of this chapter. Here you are going to learn how to create a query using Query Design and Query Wizard. So let us start how to make the query using query design. Now here we are learning the practical session of chapter 9, how to create query in design view. So query design, by using query design we are going to create a query. So first we have to create a table. Here I am using the table name as CineWorld. So my database file name is CineWorld, and in this it is first table I had created movie. In this movie I had created the structure by using design view, and from design view it is showing here the name of the fields, that is movie ID, which is data type is number, movie name, that is short text, protagonist, that is the main actor who is acting in the movie. Then category, which type of movie, it is comedy, action or emotional movie. So this way we have to create a structure and add the records. So after this I'm going to show how to add the records. So now after creating a table structure of the database file CineWorld, so first table I had created a movie, and now I will save this file, table in a file, file save, and the file is saving the table called movie. Now I want to add the record, so I will click on view, data sheet view, so I can add the records over here. So first movie ID I will put here 1001, and the name of is doctor, which is given in your book, so you can refer to the book and you can add the record name Dr. D. Doolittle 2. So okay, so Doolittle 2 is the name of the movie part 2, I think so, and the main actor was Eddie Murphy, and it is a comedy type of movie, so your category will be comedy. Now I will go to the second record. I am writing here 1002. Then the name of the movie is Fifth Element. Fifth Element is an English movie, so I am writing here Fifth Element. Then the main actress, protagonist was Bruce Willis. So Bruce Willis was a actress, and it was a action movie. So next is third record. I am giving here number 1003. Then name of the movie is Rambo V. So all are the English movies, Rambo V, and the actress was Sylvester Stallone. So the actor's name was Sylvester Stallone. We can pronounce it Stallone or Stallone. Then it was an action movie. Now next one is next record 1004. The name of the movie was Mr. Beans. You must be very familiar, comedy movie Mr. Bean, and the actor's name was, the actor is Rowan Atkinson. So his name is Rowan Atkinson. So nobody is not knowing, you can know now, the name of the Mr. Bean is Rowan Atkinson. Okay, and it's a comedy movie. So you can put here comedy movie. These are the four records I have added in the table. Now after adding the records, we can create a query. Now we can set the query using a single table also. Now here I am using only a single table on which I can create a query. So to create a query by using a query design, so you have to click on query. First save this records, click on file, click on save, then close this database, close. So the database is closed here. Now database is showing the name here, table name is movie. So the table is closed. Now here you can set the query. Now to set the query, we have to click on create, create and go to query design. So query design is given in the practical session. So I will use query design. Then which table you want to add it. So there is only one table in this Cineworld. So click on this movie and click on add. So we had clicked and we have to close it now here. The show table is closed. Now we want to set the relationship on the whichever movie I want to see. You can see your field means the field name, movie ID, movie name, protagonist, category, these are the fields. And the name of the table is movie. So second option is table name. So first select the table name, then select the field name which you want to display. So I want movie ID with movie name. Okay. So movie ID with movie name. So I want select table and movie name. So then I want the name of type of movie. So kaun se type ki movie hai that I want to make, find out. So that is my query. So select the category. So this is my query to see the movie ID, movie name and which type of movie is this. So this is my query I had set. Then third column is sort. Sort means it will display the movie name or movie ID in ascending order. So suppose I want this movie name in ascending order. So I will select here ascending or descending. If you want in descending, you can sort in ascending or descending order. So we have to select either ascending or descending, whichever option you want. So I want ascending. So then click on show. Now see, the first query is set by using query design. Now you can see over here, when I click on create query, the query tool is activated and query tool is activated design. Okay, in design you can see the different types of queries over here. So you can run the query now. There is a run query, or you can see the view tab. In the view tab you can see data sheet view, SQL view and design view. Design view means it will again go to the query in design. Okay, when I click on design view, it is showing the this is a design view. Then SQL view, this is a SQL view. Okay, then next is data sheet view. Now the data sheet view means it will display the records. So when I suppose I want to click the data sheet view here, so see this, the query output is given in the data sheet view. So this way you can create a query and see the output in the data sheet view. So this way I had create a query, first query. Now let us create a second query by using again create query design. So create query design, again select movie table, add it, then click on close, then select the table and select the field. Now I want category, only category, and the name of the actor, that is protagonist. So protagonist, I will select this and I want to display and run. So you can run the query from this run option also. First I have shown you why displaying the query in data sheet view. Now I will show you how to display the query while clicking on this run option. Click on this run. This query is already set. The run option is there. You can see category and protagonist. So these two queries I had created in query design. So same way, I will create a query using query wizard. So first, close all the queries, close all, save it, save yes, query one, give the query one name. You can give any name, movie one, yeah, movie two. So you can give the movie one as a query one. Then asking for query two, you can give movie two as a query name. So I have given here query one, movie one, and query two, movie two. So my query name is given over here. Now you can see the two queries I have set on the navigation pane. This is a table and these are the queries. So I had set the two queries, movie one, this is movie one, showing movie ID, movie name and category. Now second query is movie two, this is showing the category and protagonist. These I had created using query design. Now we will create a query using query wizard. So just click on query wizard, then here there is a four options. Select the first one, simple create query wizard, simple query wizard. Click on OK. Again, now you can see only one table is there, and it is also showing query one and query two table. So I want only table movie. So I will select this. If I want to display all, I can select all. If you want to display and remove anyone, you can remove it. Movie ID and movie name, I want to keep it. My query is to display movie ID and movie name. So I will select it, click on next. Give the query, do you want for your query, what title you want to give. So I want to give the name as movie list and ID, movie list and ID, movie ID. Okay, so here I had given the name as, title as movie list of movie ID, movie ID and movie name. So this title I had given. There are two options: open the query to view information, or you can open the query by modifying the query design. If you want to design a modify in the query, it will again go back to the query design window. So we don't want to open the query design window, we have to just open the view information. Click on next, finish. You can see the records in the table format. So your query name I had given, list of movie ID and movie name. So this is movie ID and movie name. So this way you can set the query using query wizards. So we had learned both the type of queries, how to make the query in query wizard as well as in the query design. So I hope everybody understood how to create a query very well. Chapter 9, Access Query, Practical Session. In this, you are going to use database file, student profile for creating the query. After creating the table, you are going to set the relationship on tables, then create a query using query design and query wizard. So let's get started. So today you are going to learn how to create a query in Access. For that we have to first start Access. Type here Access. We can see Access 2016 in my computer. So I will click here. then the file is already made. So I can see on the left hand side there is a pane where is name of the files are shown. So recent file, student profile. So I am opening this file. My file name is student profile. Database file name is called student profile, and in that student profile I had created two tables, student information, where I can see student information, see the record, double click it on it, you can see there are five records given over here, and the field names are GR number, roll number, student name and date of birth. So in student information there is a information regarding the roll number, student name and date of birth, and the primary key is set on GR number. So second table is student details. In this table we can see the fields like GR number, age, birthplace, state and country. So in student information there is a personal data, and in the student detail it is about the birthplace, age, state, country and GR number. Same here also, GR number is a primary key and we have to set the relation on GR number. For that we have to first close all the files, table files. So you have close it, go to database tool, select the relationship. Now here you can see a show table which is asking for which table you want to add it. So I will add both file, both table file. So just I am clicking on student information, add it, second student detail, add, then close it. So here the relation is already set on the GR number. If you want to set the GR number relationship, so you can set the relationship by dragging it on same field of each table. So it is asking you to save it, click on yes. Then you can see the table shown over here of relationship. Here you can see the GR number from student information and GR number from student detail. So though both the fields are common, and we have set relation on this GR number, where primary key is set on GR number of both the tables. So click on OK, the relation will be set on GR number. So if you want to make any modification, you can do the modification in the design tool. Now you can see here the relationship tool is opening in design. So in design you can get all the options like edit relationship, clear layout, then relation report, show table, all the other relationship which is set can be seen over here in the design tool of relationship tools. And if you want to close the relationship, so you can close it. Now why we should set the relation on GR number? Suppose we want the records from this table, so we have to relate with first table also. So student information is related with student detail, so we can get any record from any of the table. So that is why we have to set the relation. Now close the relationship, close it. You want to save it, save it, yes. Now it is, the relationship table is closed. Now we have to set the query. After setting the relationship we can set the query. So to set the query we have to click on create button, create, then query design. So you have to make use of query design, select query wizard. So query wizard you have to select it, then select the simple query wizard. So simple query wizard, we can click on this. Okay, we are using a simple query, so click on simple query wizard. Now you can see there are two tables over displayed over here, student detail and student information. These are the two table which is created in student profile database. So whichever fields you want, you can add it in the field box. So you can add on which the query is to be set. Suppose I am taking from student information GR number, select it, then student name, student roll number and date of birth. Okay, so I have taken three fields. I don't want this student name, I will take it back. So I have taken GR number, roll number and date of birth. Then click on next. Then click on again, click on next or finish. So you can add the query title over here. You can give the summary of the query and you can click on next. You can give the title here, query for student roll number, query for student roll number. So I am giving here title, query for student roll number. So click on finish. So you can see the GR number, roll number and date of birth. So this is one query. I had not given student name, so I had add only the three fields from student information. So I have taken the fields from student information and you can see the query for student roll number. So according to GR number, the roll number is also set for them. So it is displaying the student roll number and date of birth. Now second query, if you want to set by using query design, so you can click on this query design. You have to make use of again from which table you want to make the query, add it, add both. So you have to select both and click on both. So select this, add, select second one, add and close it. Now here you can see fields. Fields means these are the fields of the table of student detail and this is the fields of student information. From which table you want to select, you can select it here in the field column. Then second is given table. So which table you want, whether you want student details or student information, you can select it over here. Then third one option is sort. So for displaying the records in ascending or descending order in a query, so you can make use of sort. Then show. Show means which we want to show it, I can show it. Then criteria means any condition if you want to put, greater than, less than, equal to, name start with S, etc. So these are the criteria can be set in the query. Now my query is I want student, from student information I want to select the table student information. First select the table, second one is table student information, then select fields. Now the fields will be displayed here of student information. I want roll number. Then second field also same, I want student information, I want the name of the student, student name, so I can take it, select student name. Then from the student detail, I have to select the table first, student detail, then select the field is birthplace, then next is from student detail, I want the field state, and from same student details I want select the student details, select the field country. So from student information I have selected roll number, student name, from student information table, from this table I have selected roll number and student name from this table. Now from the second table I have selected birthplace, state and country. So this is because we have set the relation, we can select the field from both the tables. So this is the use of setting the relation, so where we can make use in the queries, in the forms, in the reports, etc. So this is the use of setting the relation in database. So here I have already set my query. Now I want to display the records in ascending. So I want the name should be displayed in the ascending order. So I will select here ascending. Now the query is already set. So you can see here run command. So run command is available over here. First save the file. So create file, save it. save the query 1. It is asking query 1. So I am giving the query name as birthplace, student birthplace. So student birthplace is my query name. So I had find out the birthplace of the student. So I had given the query name as birthplace, student birthplace. So click on OK. Now you can see the click on run command. The output will be shown here. Now you can see roll number, student name from student information, and birthplace, state and country from student detail. So this way we can set the query to find out the records from the database tables. So these are the two tables which I had already used. Now this is the first query. This is query of GR number, roll number and date of birth. And the second query is setting the birthplace of the student and state and country. So this is the second query. Now here you can see on the pane, navigation pane, there are two queries given here. So I had made two queries which is showing the subtopic as queries and the query files. So these are the query tables. So whenever I want to see any queries, I can just, I'm closing this, close all. Now you can just click on see the first query of roll number. Then you can close it, right click, close. Then second query, you can see the name of the student, birthplace, country, state and country. So this way we can set the relation and create a query using different tables of database. So it can be more than 2, 3, 4, you can, as many tables can be added in a table, and we can set the relation and we can make the query. So these are the two methods to create the query. We can create a query to query wizard, and we can create a query to by using query design. So I hope everybody has understood the query session. So we'll stop here. I hope you have enjoyed this lesson of creating the query. Thank you. So this is exercise which you have to write in your notebook. Student, always remember, when there is written exercise, you have to write in your notebook. When it is given assignment, you have to write separately on paper. And by using MCB app, you have to upload it on computer also. So this is an exercise, only fill in the blanks are there from A to J. So you write down in your notebook. Here I had given you all the answers of the fill in the blanks. So just you have to write down, copy down this, all the fill in the blanks in a good handwriting in your notebook. Mask up India to stop coronavirus. Please, please wear mask, wash your hands and keep social distancing. Maje kutumba, maji jawabdari. Remember this for your family and friends. Thank you. Goodbye.